So today we'll start with the column splices. So column splices we already know, because what happened if you take a multi-story building, so we can't manufacturing a single column for a height of 15 meters or 13 meters. So we need to connect column by different column we have to connect, or you can say same sizes of the section will connect to the at a certain height. But here you have to understand the thing is different types of column splices. The column splices is only a flat plate which is provided in the flanges, or some cases is provided in the web. But depending upon different types of the column and different types of the load, if we'll discuss in the class, in the next class, what is the design procedure for the column splices. First we'll try to understand different types of column splices. So column splices, the plate which is provided to connecting two different column or same plate or different plates. Okay, so now here we have four different types of columns. So first we have to understand, this is the first diagram which is show A. Here we given top column and bottom column. Okay, bottom column at a certain height it is end. Now we have to one more plate, same size of the plate we have to connect. Here when you see the column A, both the column having same size, this is shows the front elevation of the column, where bottom column is connected with the top column, but both the diagrams and both the column size is same. If you consider ISMB or ISHB 250, means top and bottom will be same, ISHB 250 or ISMB 400. So now here you can see splice plate that is connected between two column. Here the main thing you have to understand, we have to design actually first is splice plate width, thickness, and the length. It is depends upon the number of bolts that we can calculate after providing the number of bolts. Only we have to calculate here, just understand, two bottom column and top column having same diagram, same dimensions, so we connected without any problem in the flanges. So this splice plate is provided, here also a splice plate is provided, but here the number of bolts always providing is even number. We can't provide odd number of the bolts. Always you use, if we got three number also we can provide only four number, you can't provide three number of bolts. So this is case one, where the top and bottom column is same. Second case two, if you understand here, the column, bottom column is bigger than top column, means the top bottom column is bigger and top column is smaller. Here what happened, we have to provide some filler plate. How we calculate filler plate? This filler plate is providing exactly because we have to provide butt joint. If you require both the plates are different sizes, means we provide some packing plate. Here not packing plate, they just say has filler plate. What is filler plate? Means we have to check the depth of the top bottom column and minus width of the depth of the top column divided by 2, will get the two types of filler plate. Here also we can design with the splice plate, but here you have to calculate that second case, you have to calculate the width of the filler plate. So third case, here also we can calculate filler plate, but here we providing web plate. Why we providing web plate? Because here we are acting shear force. If shear force is acting in the beam, means if the column is, we have to provide web plate. So web plate, so here also this is the third type, where we can see that both the columns are different sizes, and here we have to provide filler plate and we are providing web plate. When you providing web plate, when the shear force is acting here. So third, fourth case and final case is last one, that we say both the columns are different plate, different sizes, but filler plate thickness is more compared to last two cases. So that's why we have to providing bearing plate, that we can see here at the center, we can provide the filler bearing plate also. Okay, so these are four different types of cases we can say. First case is the both the columns are same size. Second case, both the columns are different size, but here we providing the filler plate. Fourth case is where the shear force also given here. So these are the cases in which cases we can understand is all four types of design. These are all four cases of column splices we designed in the next class. So this is the first class we can understand. Okay, this much is enough for first. So we can understand column splices and different types of column splices.